So stability studies, in the stability studies, the topics we are going to cover today is, we'll see what is stability studies, we'll see the overview, okay, what are stability studies, then we'll see the stability studies process flow, okay, basically what activities we are doing in the stability studies process, okay, and then we will understand how to do the planning in the stability studies, okay, how the planning is done, and then finally we'll see how to execute the stability studies. Okay, so what is basically stability studies? Stability studies, or they are also called as shelf life studies, okay, are performed normally in the chemical, pharmaceutical and food industries. Okay, so these are normally, the stability studies are performed in process industries, chemical, pharmaceutical and food kind of industries, to examine how different environmental conditions, okay, like environmental conditions like your temperature, moisture, brightness, so these kind of things affect your product, okay, over a period of time. Suppose if you observe carefully, if you go to a pharmacy, if you buy some medicines, okay, if you buy some medicines, what you will see on the medicine, normally what you will observe, you will observe batch number, okay, you will see batch number, you will see manufacturing date, and you will see expiry date, right? Correct. So we will be seeing these details on the medicines, like your tablets or your capsules or syrups or those things. Now the question is, how this expiry date is calculated? That is the question. Okay. So this expiry date is normally calculated through your stability studies. Okay. Through stability studies, we will be calculating the expiry date, shelf life date. That is what we'll be doing in the, normally they do in the real time. Okay, just give me 1 minute. Just give me 1 minute. Okay, so basically you will be performing to see how your product conditions over a period of time. Okay, so you consider like environmental condition like temperature, moisture and brightness. So these things you will consider. So now the stability studies are carried out to determine the shelf life of a product. So basically these are carried out to determine the, ultimately to calculate the shelf life of a product. So shelf life means till how much duration you can use that particular product or a material. Okay, so that is what shelf life. You might have heard the word SLED, right? Yeah. SLED, shelf life expiration date. I'll show you this where you maintain in the system, in the SAP, shelf life expiration date. Okay, so this, to calculate this one expiry, you will use the stability studies. Okay, so basically what we will be doing here is, we will be taking the product, and the product is stored under controlled conditions during the duration of the study. Okay, for the entire shelf life study duration, what you will do, you store the product under controlled conditions, different controlled condition, which are called storage conditions. Okay, so you store it over here. Now it specified intervals during the study. So now once the specified duration is reached, you remove these samples or part of these samples from the various conditions and you test them. Okay, you test them. So what you will be doing here is, once that interval is reached, you remove that samples and then you will test them. Test for all the quality parameters. So that is what you will be doing in the stability studies. Okay, so you can use the results of these tests which have accumulated over the course of study to confirm whether the desired or guaranteed life expectancy of the product conforms to the predefined recommendations for storage. So you whatever the when you inspect, you will be getting your results. So that results you will store, you will maintain certain your course of the study, and then you will see whether particular period still your product life expectancy is guaranteed or not. So that is what you will be doing it in the stability studies. Okay, so this is the process flow of stability studies. First I will give you just brief overview, then you will be able to understand. So what they do here is, first you define your environmental conditions. Okay, here your environmental conditions. Environmental conditions you define here, this side. Okay, and then you define your period over here, let's say, or period interval, period. Okay, so you take your product. So let's say your environmental condition, I will define temperature. Let's say my environmental condition is temperature. Let's say you store it 10 degrees, and then you store it at room temperature. Okay. And then you store it at, let's say, 35 degrees. I'm just giving you example. Okay, and then you store it at, let's say, -10. Okay, you store it at -10. Okay, so you store the product at different environmental condition. Now the next one is period. So let's say 1 month, now let's say 3 months, and then 6 months. Okay, then 1 year, then 1 year, and then 3 years. Okay, and then 5 years. Like this, this is your period. Okay, so this is your period. So now what they do is, let's say you have a product for which you want to carry out stability studies. You take this product. Okay, now you store this in this, let's say you have, let's say you are inspecting 100 kg of a material. So you take, you put the product here, 1 kg, 1 kg, 1 kg, 1 kg, you put it over here. Okay, so now all this you will store. Okay, now what happens is, let's say you started study from today. What is the date? 25/09/2016. So you start your studies today. Now once the 1 month is reached, let's say 1 month means 25/10/2016. Once this period is reached, what they do is, they take out these samples. Once the 1 month is reached, they take out these samples. Okay, they will test it. Okay, so now they will check for the different analysis at different stages. Again, environmental condition, they take out this 1 kg, they check out, they check quality parameters, all the required quality parameters. Now room temperature sample, they will take, they inspect 35 degrees, minus degrees, everything they will check, they will test it. If all results are okay, good, that's good. Okay, now once the 3 months is reached, 3 months means 25/12/2016, once the 3 months is reached, they'll take out these samples and then they will do the testing. Okay, let's say you, it's everything is okay. Now 6 months, 6 months means 25, what is the date, sir? 03, right? 03/2016. Okay, then they, once the 6 months is reached, whatever the samples they store for 6 months, they take out and they will test it. Like this, they will do the, what do you say, stability studies. Now let's say after 3 years is reached, let's say 3 years means 2019. Now when they test the samples, let's say, room temperature, it is okay. Room temperature is okay, but at 35 degrees, let's say it is failing. Results are failing. Or even room temperature, let's say results are failing. You tested it, results are failing, not okay. Okay, then they determine the shelf life of this product as 3 years. Okay, so this is how you do the stability studies. So you store your product under different environmental conditions for different periods. Okay, and then once that particular period is reached, you take out those samples and you will do the analysis, and you will check the quality of your product or material. Okay, once the product is not meeting your quality specifications or criteria, that will be determined as your expiry. So here in our case, it is 3 years. After 3 years, if it is failing, then that will be determined as your expiry. So that is what they do, 3 years as they maintain. And one more thing is, why the environmental conditions is maintained is, let's say if you maintain the product at 50 degrees temperature, okay, by 1 year itself it's get failed here. So 50 degrees, in the 1 year itself it's get failed. This sample will fail for 1 year itself. That is why if you observe on your medicines, you will be able to see a suggestion called direction. That please store the product or medicine at room temperature. Have you observed any time? Sorry. So you observe direction for us, or a instruction for us on medicines, that you store the product at cool temperature. Why? Because if it is stored at higher temperatures or something, then the product will get degraded much earlier than your normal expiry period. So if you observe on the medicines, I'll show you. I don't know whether you observed this any time or not. You will have directions. You will have actually store under cooled temperatures. You will have here actually. I'll show you that here we are not getting actually. We normally you will have a direction called store under a cool temperature or like that, you will have the images actually. Okay. Here you are able to see store below 25 degrees. Are you able to see? Here it is there. Store below 25 degrees. Protected from light and moisture. So why they give this direction? Why they give this direction means it will have, if you store it more than 25 degrees or something, what happens is product may degrade very soon. That is why they give this direction, because of that. Okay, so that is how your stability studies is carried out. So this is the idea behind. Now we need to understand how this is done, how this is executed in the SAP system. We need to understand. Okay, so this is how the process flow works in SAP system. Okay, so the process flow is, you first create the stability study. Okay, I'll show you that how it works. You first create the stability study in the system. You create the stability study. Okay, so in this stability study, you create initial sample, you confirm the initial sample, all those things you will do, and first you do initial testing. Okay, first you do initial testing. Okay, so that means first the initial sample you will test. Okay, initial sample you test it, you create an inspection lot for that, you perform it. If it is okay, if the initial sample is okay, then you carry out your stability studies. Or if the initial sample itself is failing, there is no point in doing stability studies. Okay, so that's what the meaning. So you do initial testing. If it is okay, then you start stability planning. In the stability planning, you will define your storage conditions, the one which I explained, the temperature, moisture, whatever I explained. Then you define your testing schedule. That means the period of interval. 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, all those things, you will define it here. And then you proceed with your stability study. Okay, so when you, as the period is reached, you take out the samples, you carry out the testing. And once all the activities have been done, you will complete your stability study. So this happens in like three phases. One is, first you create the stability study, initial testing you do, and then you do continue with stability testing. So this is the basic process flow in the stability studies. Okay, so now let's see it in the system. So this is how it works. Total process, it works. Okay, we'll see this in the step by step in the system. You create stability study. First, create stability study. Then you create initial sample. Then you perform inspection for your initial sample. Once all done, then you start with your stability studies. This is what you are going to do. It happens in three phases basically. Stability study, first creation, initial stability study creation. Then initial testing, initial sample testing. Once that is okay, good, then you will proceed to the your final stability studies, like storage condition, testing schedule, storing the samples, then you define the startup cycle, and then you schedule it, and accordingly you will be finally, once all the 6-5 years, 3 years or 5 years is reached, once all done, you will close your stability study. So this is how you do the stability study. So we'll start it in the system. Okay, so normally stability studies, to carry out stability studies, you will be using quality notification. You will be using a quality notification in the system. So your stability studies is carried out by using a stability study, quality notification, and then you will be using a testing schedule. This comes from normally from planned maintenance module. It comes from planned maintenance module. In this testing schedule, you define the period. Okay, and then you will use some physical sample records. This also will do, will treat in the system. And then when you do the scheduling, ultimately your inspection lots will get generated. See, ultimately to do quality inspection, we need an inspection lot. So that inspection lot ultimately you have to generate once that period is reached. Okay, so this is how your stability studies is planned in the system. So now let's start it in the system. I'll explain about this testing schedule once we go into the flow. So how would you do it is, just we'll log on to the system. Okay, so let's go to logistics. Let's go to logistics, quality management. Okay, go to stability study. Stability study. Okay, go to stability study, create. The transaction code is QST01. Okay, in standard SAP, you process through this transaction. Okay, create QST01. It's like a, whatever we are doing is like a workflow today. Okay, it's a workflow. Just understand the flow. Whatever I'm doing, I have documented with step-by-step screenshots. So don't worry on the flow part. Try to understand the concept. So here, stability study is executed through a, with a notification, with a quality notification. Only thing is, you use a different notification type. Okay, so here you take the one which I'm going to use is QS, stability study with material, QS. So you select this one. Okay, enter. Okay, so it is asking, it is external numbering, so you give a name to it. So Puneet underscore stability studies. Okay, so this is the name of my notification. Enter. Invalid outside number reach. Okay, enter. Okay, so you will be getting this screen. You will be going to this screen. Okay, and here you have the, if you see on the right side, you have an action box. So where you are, you will be performing all your actions. Okay, all your actions. So first we need to enter the material. For which material you want to do stability studies, that material you need to enter. I'm taking this material. Okay, I'm taking this material which is already there in the system. Enter the material and you enter the plant. My plant is 1100. I want to use it in this plant. Okay, enter. Enter. And if you have any batch data, if you have for this product, if already some stock will be there, that if that stock is having batch, you can enter that batch. Let me take the batch. Just 1 minute. Let me go to MMBE stock overview. These are basically tablets, I think. Stock is not there. Okay, let me create some stock. I'll create some stock. I want to have batch. Okay, so let us do, let us create some stock. So I'm saving this. So now you have some stock. I have created a 10,000 pieces of tablets. Normally, whatever we are discussing stability studies is normally in pharma industries they do. Pharmaceutical industries, it's must. But only the question is whether execute this in SAP or that is a different. That is a question. Okay. So let me go to the slash and MLB. I'll go to stock overview again. This is our material. Execute. Okay, so this is the stock we have and its batch number is this one. So now for this stock, using this stock we'll be carrying out stability studies. So now let me take that batch number and enter the batch number over here. Okay, done. All data entered. Now you can write some text description over here. Okay, if you want to write description, you can write the description over here. Now once that is done, once the data is entered, you save your notification first. So your notification is created. Okay, so your notification is created. Now go to notification change mode. You go to change mode, enter. Okay, so now you will be carrying out the notification process. So you'll be continuing with the notification process. So first step is you will be creating the initial sample. Okay. So you will be creating the initial sample. Before that, you need to put the notification is in process. Put the notification in process. So that means we are going to with this notification process. So save it first. Save it first. Okay. Now go again inside. Now start with create initial sample. We are here now. We are here. We created the stability study. Now we'll be creating the initial sample. So just click on the button create initial sample. Okay, so you will be getting this screen. So your material, your plant, your batch, your notification number, okay, and physical sample type and your sample category is initial sample. So here you can enter whatever the data you want. Okay, that means in which container you are taking the sample and what is your sample quantity, all those things you will enter here. So let me take the primary packaging. Okay, so I'm taking in a blister packages. Okay, blister packages, take this one. This comes from configuration. I'll show you in the configuration. This primary packaging will come from configuration. So take that. Now from the, that means samples are available in these blisters. Now from that blister, I took the sample and ultimately where I put that samples, I put it in the, let's say, test tube. Let's say I put them in the test tube. Now what is my sample quantity? Let's say my sample quantity is, let's say, 10 pieces, 10 tablets I have taken. Sample quantity, enter your unit of measure. It is pieces. Okay. Now initial sample, where you are storing. First initial sample. It is at normal room temperature. And even the storage conditions will come from configuration. When I go to configuration, I will show you. Okay. So you enter your sample location. This is a, where you are storing it. Again, this comes from configuration. This all this storage data comes from configuration. So I'll store it in warehouse or my warehouse. Okay, you can write some short text over here. Initial sample for stability studies. You write that remarks whatever you want here and then you click on this button. Create initial sample and save change notification. So we are creating here a physical sample. Here we are creating physical sample. Try to recollect our physical sample classes. Every physical sample will have a number, unique number, right? So now it will create a physical sample. So just click on the button, create initial sample and save change notification. Okay, so it will create a initial sample. So you save it first. Okay, again go inside, again, go inside. Now change initial sample. Okay, it's all data has come. All data has come. Good. Okay, save it once. Okay, now confirm the initial sample. So just click on the button. Now you confirm it. So when you confirm it, system will be generating an inspection log. Okay, system will be generating. That means you are releasing the initial sample. Okay, you are releasing it. Okay, continue. Okay, now system will be generating an inspection log automatically. Okay, so now when you release it, it will generate a log. So go to QA32, you will be able to see a log for initial testing. Go to QA32. What is today's date? 25th, right? 25. Enter your dates and the plant. If you want to enter, you can enter material also. Just click on execute. What has not come? Just wait. Ah, sorry. You need to confirm the sample, right? Then you do the initial test inspection lot. Sorry. Here you go here and you now create the lot. Okay, so here you will be creating the lot. So this is a physical sample which we got generated. This is the initial sample number. Okay, so even if you want to see the data, you can go and see the data. If you go to create session, what is the transaction code to see the sample? Just wait. Go to quality management, quality inspection, sample management, physical sample display, QPR3. Okay, so if you go, this is the physical sample got generated. If you go to inside, you'll be able to see all the data. So this is the material number, this is the batch number. Okay, all the sample details you'll be getting. This is the initial sample, in which container we have taken, test tube, and these are the sample quantity, 10 pieces. All those data you'll be able to. So system is generating a physical sample. Now for this physical sample, we are generating an inspection lot. Okay, we are generating the inspection lot. So now you have the inspection type here, 1601. This is the standard inspection type you have to use for stability studies for initial sample. So if you select the inspection type, if you see normal stability studies, you will be using 16. For initial testing, you will be using 1601. That's what you need to understand. So you should be thorough with the inspection type you are going to use. So that is the inspection type. Now you assign the inspection plan. Specifications you have to assign, right? So all your MICs will come from your inspection plan. So that inspection plan you need to assign. So let us check whether this material is having any inspection plan. It should have an inspection plan, QP03. Okay, so this is my material, this is a plant, enter. See, you should know from where the data is getting picked up. Okay, so this is the inspection plan is already there. Go to the header. So here, this is the group and group counter. So this group and group counter we need to enter over there. That means which inspection plan we are going to use. So enter the group and group counter. Okay, then you write some remarks over here. Okay, and then now you click on this button, create inspection lot. Okay, so we are here basically. We are now creating the inspection lot for initial testing. We are here. Okay, so now let's click on the button create. So now your lot will get generated. Okay, so system is proposing you the characteristics from the inspection plan. Okay, so if you go to the inspection plan, there are two characteristics maintained. If you go to operation, go to characteristics. Okay, so you have two characteristics here. That's what it's proposing. So now system is asking you whether you want to test all the MICs or you want to test only one or two. But I want to test all, select all. You can select here or you can click on this button, select all. Okay, so select all, then click on copy all. So all characteristics will be get copied to the inspection lot and your inspection lot will get created. Okay, so your lot get created and you save your notification. Now you will be able to see the lot in the QA32. See, now your lot has come. Now your inspection lot has come. Now the lot number starts with 16. The lot number starting with 16. That means it is a stability studies relevant inspection lot. And now the lot is already released. Because we have already assigned the inspection plan to the lot. So now go to the lot. Now you perform initial testing. So you perform initial test and you enter all your results in the initial test inspection lot, in this lot. So let us do the results recording. So you enter your physical sample number. What is our physical sample number? Just 1 minute. Let me go back. QPR3, right? What is the sample, this one? Just wait. Go to display, notification, enter. No, we cannot go to change mode, I think. Okay, we can go to change mode. Go to document flow. What was the initial sample number? Just 1 minute. This is the initial sample number. 9123 45100. Okay, that initial sample number you can enter. 5 0s 1 2 3 4 5 1 0 0 1 0 0. So you enter this for this physical sample we tested and we are doing the results. So now let me come out of this, because if this is open again we will get some errors. So just continue. Okay, done. You got your characteristics. Click on 1 to 1. Okay, then you enter your results. Let's say my potency is 40% and my color is a qualitative. So let's say my color is light red. So enter. Done. You see it. So initial testing is completed. Now you do the usage decision. Results recording is done. You do the usage decision. Okay. So I'm doing the usage decision here. Complete initial testing and stability will be executed. If it is failing, then you will use this code normally. But it's passed. It's okay. Initial testing. So you will do with this code. Enter. Done. Now you save it. Okay. Done. Then it's okay. Your initial testing has been completed. So we are here now. We are completed this one. We completed this part. We created stability study. We created initial sample. For the initial sample, we created the inspection log. We performed initial testing, and then we completed initial testing. This part is done. As this is okay, we are now continuing with our stability studies process. That's what we are going to do. Okay. So now where are we? Now go to the notification again. Enter. Okay, now you start with initial test has been done. Now you complete your initial test. You just take this action box. Functions you selected. Done, right? Initial test. Okay, let me assign the priority. Enter. Done, right? Initial inspection lot. Released it. Initial test completed. Okay. Initial test completed, right? Already. Yeah. It's completed. So that's why it's not completed also. So they say now you start with specifying storage conditions. So now we are here. We are now defining the storage conditions. So here you go. Click on the button specify storage conditions. So now here you storage conditions. Your storage conditions have come. Okay. So now here in the storage conditions, you maintain how much quantity you are going to put. So here this one we are going to do. How much quantity you are going to enter at different places. Okay. So now let me enter here 30. Let me here 30. Let me here enter 30. 30. 30. Let me enter. So this storage condition, 30 pieces I'm maintaining. This storage condition, 30. This storage condition, 30. Now these storage conditions will come from configuration. I'll show it in the configuration also. SPR. Go to SAP reference IMG. Scroll down. Go to quality management. Okay, go to stability study. Go to basic data. Here you are able to see define storage conditions. So here you will maintain. Okay, see how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are there. So those 5 here coming here. Those 5 are coming here. Now here you maintain how much quantity you are going to maintain particular, you are going to store at that particular storage condition that you enter the quantity. Okay, so just give me 1 minute. Okay, so now once you enter all those things, select all, okay, and then you specify storage conditions and save change notification. Quantity for storage condition is greater than quantity of initial sample. Okay, not a problem. Okay, and then you save it. What it's asking, you not allowing to save on. Okay, let's put small quantity. Let's put only 5. Okay, now save it. Okay, done. Your specifying storage conditions is done. Okay, now you need to create this testing schedule. Now you have to define this period. You have to define this testing schedule. These periods you have to define. Okay, so now go here, create testing schedule. Okay. So here you go, maintenance plan I'm creating. It is coming as same as notification. Now maintenance plan category is this one. Here you need to maintain the strategy. So this maintenance strategy comes from plan maintenance module. So in this strategy, they will define this period. Okay, I'll show you that. We'll maintain some strategy. Okay, I'll maintain this one, QSTA-B1, stability study strategy. Now I'll show you this. Let us go to some other screen and show you this. Go to plan maintenance, go to plan maintenance. Okay, go to preventive maintenance, go to maintenance planning, go to maintenance strategy. Okay, now go to IP11 change. Here you will have all your maintenance strategies. Okay, so the one which we are going to use is this one, QSTA-B1. Now if you go to the folder packages, here you have this one. See, this is a after 1 month, after 2 months, after 3 months, after 6 months, after 9 months. So this stability study, these are the your intervals. This is called packages. Okay, normally this maintenance strategy will be created by your PM consultant. You need to take help of your PM consultant. He will be creating for you. Okay, so that strategy you need to assign it over here. So we have assigned it here. Now finally, overall your scheduling period is how much? Here it is maintained as 5 years, right? 72 months means how much? 5 years, huh? 60 months. Let's put 60 months only. Okay, let us maintain is 5 years. 5 years. Okay, I'll select the scheduling period. 5 years. It should be there as maintained as years. Here, 5 year. Time is there that you need to maintain. Okay. There is a creating testing schedule. Assign the maintenance strategy. Scheduling period 5 years. So you maintain that. And inspection type, it will come as default 60. For stability studies, the inspection type is 60. So this is the testing schedule we are creating. Here we are mentioning your intervals and your overall scheduling period. Both you define duration, overall duration and the intervals. Intervals are maintained in this strategy. You should know from which places the data is coming. Okay, so that's how you maintain here. Testing schedule. We are here. We are defined the storage conditions. Now we are defining this testing schedule. Okay, so now once all the data is entered, just click on the button create testing schedule. Number is not in external interval. That again the PM issue. Just give me 1 minute. I know the problem where it is. It is in the configuration. Some PM configuration is missing. Just give me 1 minute. So that maintenance plan category is not having number range. That is a problem. That's why that you are getting that error. Okay. Anyhow, I have done that. Now let us do it again. Let me save this first. Okay. Let me do that again. There is a tiered testing schedule, strategy, period. I entered. So now your maintenance plan will get created. Okay, so your maintenance plan is get created. Now you go and store the samples. So now you go and store the samples in that particular period. So just click on the button. Now next action box, store and store stability samples. Okay, here. Okay, so you are on this date, you are storing the samples. 5555. Already we maintain the quantity. And then you determine the sample location. Sample location, I will enter all same. This one, I will copy the one. Okay, this is the one. Select all, and then you save. Quantity of sample storage conditions exceeds quantity of initial sample. You have taken initial sample more. That is a problem. Not saving. Okay, we'll do one thing, we'll put only one more. Okay, so your notification got saved. You stored the stability samples. Now what you use, you define now your you define your start date of study. So you go here. What is that? Store stability samples is done. Complete test scheduling. Complete change testing schedule. Yes. Yeah, okay, all physical samples got created. That's okay. Okay, now you define start date of study. Why it is not taking? Okay, you need to make changes in the maintenance plan. Okay, now your maintenance plan is created, right? For the same notification, your plan is there. So you need to assign parameters to your maintenance plan. So you just go to IP0, IP11, IP11. Not IP11, wait. Go to logistics, plan maintenance, preventive maintenance, work schedule.
IP02.
Yeah, IP02, I think. Oh, schedule. IP10. IP02, changes IP02, right? So go to IP02. Okay, so this is your maintenance plan. Here you will for this items, maintenance items, physical sample, you will assign your that quality inspection plan. So you go here, select the items. Just 1 minute. You go here, you select all, go to item. Here you assign your inspection plan. Okay, so it is 39.1. Go to next one. We have 5 items, right? So go to next one. Assign the inspection plan, group counter 1. Next one you go. That you assigned all the inspection plans to each item, your each item. Okay, that means at every condition what parameters you are going to check, that you are defining over here. Okay, now you save it. Okay, now go to the notification. Go to the notification again. Let's stay once. Now let's go back again. Okay, now you define your start date of study. Why it's not allowing? Just 1 minute. All tasks completed, detailed info. Why it's not allowing to change it? Change test scheduling. Yes. Header we have, right?
Go to schedule parameter.
Yeah, yeah.
Here you have to give start date.
We will create it. But actually there itself we will be able to give actually. Not sure why it is taking here. Okay.
But there is some user status which is restricting that.
Yeah, some user status they maintain it seems. Somebody change the settings. Yeah. Okay. So you define your startup cycle over here. Okay, startup cycle over here. Enter. And then you save it. There on the notification itself it should come actually. Not sure what happened. Okay, so now you defined your start date of study. Okay, now you what happens is they schedule this maintenance plan actually in the real time. This maintenance plan is there. This will, they will be scheduling in the background job. There is a transaction called IP30. There is a transaction called IP30. Deadline monitoring. Deadline monitoring of maintenance plan. Here you enter your maintenance plan. And then this will be running as a background job every day. So when what happens is we defined our what is our start date today, 25/09/2016. Okay, now what is the first interval? 1 month. So on when 25/10/2016 date is reached, system will be automatically creating the lots. Okay, so I'll schedule it manually. So actually in the real time this will be running as a background job daily at a predefined interval. So I'll go to IP10, enter. Okay, now you click on start. Okay, so this is the startup cycle which we already maintained. Now you click on continue. See, next first 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, whatever the intervals we defined in the maintenance strategy, so those have come. Okay, in real time you will not be doing this in the front end. Okay, it happens through a background job which I have shown you, the transaction IP30. Okay, so now again that IP30 configuring that scheduling the background job, normally PM consultants will do. Okay, it comes under the PM module. Okay, so now when you release this first item, once the 1 month is reached, automatically it will get released. So select that item and then you click on the release call button. So you released it, automatically you will be getting lots. That means the date is reached. That day you have to inspect the samples. So you will be getting 5 inspection lots. Okay. So if you go to our QA32/QA32, you will be getting your 5 inspection lots. Actually, we generated inspection lots 1 month in advance only. Actually, if you see it properly, see. This is the one, our initial sample which we completed. Now you see, there are 5 samples created. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Why 5 inspection lots have come? For each storage condition, 1 lot. Each storage condition, 1 lot. Our storage conditions are 5. That is why 5 lots have come. So you take the sample from that storage condition and then you inspect it. And you enter all the results in this inspection lots. Like this, the process will go on. Next, second month is reached, again one more 5 inspection lots will come. Like this the process will continue. Okay, so when you schedule it, you will be getting the inspection lots. Ultimately from QM perspective, you should get your inspection lot at that time. So this is what we discussed. Okay, so you create a strategy, time based strategy, in that you determine interval 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, whatever you are. And we created already storage conditions. At what storage conditions you want to store the samples. Okay, and then you, for the items, you assign the inspection plan. So with inspection plan, what you want to use, what characteristics you want to check, all those things comes from inspection plan. And when you schedule the maintenance plan, as per the scheduling, you will be getting the inspection logs. Okay, so this is how the stability studies will work. Okay, so the once that second month is reached, again you will be getting one more 5 inspection lots. Third month, Okay, then as per the packages you defined in the what do you say in your strategy. So that is how it's happened. So now once all the activities have been done, once all the period is reached, all 5 years, all the testing has been done, finally you'll click on this button, complete stability study, the last from the last one, second one from the last, complete stability study. Of course here it will not allow because still that status outstanding dates are existing, completion not possible because in between all the activities have to be done, right? So that's why it's not allowed. But once all the done, all activities have been done, finally you'll be completing the stability study. This one. Completion of stability study. This one, the last one. Okay. So this is how your stability studies are carried out in the system. Okay. The major important thing is in the stability studies is one is your storage conditions. Storage conditions. Okay. And the another one is your strategy. Your strategy. That means your periods. And storage conditions, your conditions, with what condition you want to store. So these are very important. This we will define storage condition. As a QM consultant, you will define. And this periods, period intervals, which is determined creating maintenance strategy in plan maintenance. Your plan maintenance consultant will do this for you. Okay. So these two things are you should take care during the stability studies. Now while doing the stability studies, after some period your product will get failed. After 3 years, let's say, or after 5 years it's getting failed, then that 3 years will be determined as your expiry. Okay. So this is how your stability studies are carried out.